Tesla is no longer preparing for the robotaxi era. The company is already building the system today, piece by piece, across regulation, software, infrastructure, and business models. And what happened in the last 24 hours shows that the shift has quietly begun. Hi, this is Ken. If you are a Tesla investor, today's developments are not isolated headlines. Together, they reveal Tesla's real trajectory for the next decade, how revenue will shift from selling cars to operating them, how FSD is positioning itself for commercial use, and how early regulatory signals can impact long-term valuation before Wall Street catches on. By the end of this video, you'll see why these changes are deeply connected and why they could reshape the financial foundation of Tesla as a business. Before diving into the deeper analysis, here are the key updates from the past day. First, Arizona has officially granted Tesla a statewide license to operate paid robotaxi services, not a city trial, not a limited zone, the entire state. Second, Tesla has begun the broad rollout of FSD version 14.2, featuring major improvements in perception, emergency vehicle detection, and high-resolution scene understanding. Third, Tesla has launched its new rental program across multiple US cities, offering rentals from only $60 per day with unlimited miles and free supercharging. Fourth, the world's first third-party branded supercharger site has opened in Florida, operated by a local company using Tesla's V4 hardware. And finally, the Model X has undergone a massive weight reduction, up to 400 pounds or 180 kilograms, improving efficiency and lowering operating costs. Individually, these may feel like small updates. Together, they form a pattern. Now let's break down what that pattern really means. Arizona's decision is extraordinary because regulatory approvals for autonomous driving almost always begin with small, restricted areas. Waymo, Cruise, Zoox, all of them gained approval city by city, block by block, often under heavy limitations. But Arizona just told Tesla, you can operate paid autonomous services across the entire state. This suggests two things. First, Tesla's accumulated FSD data, combined with the pace of improvement in version 14, has reached a threshold that regulators consider adequate for commercial experimentation. Second, the state is effectively signaling that Tesla's system generalizes well beyond specific geofenced zones. This changes the narrative completely. Tesla's path is not start small, prove safety in one neighborhood, expand slowly. Instead, Tesla might begin deployments at a statewide scale from day one, and this sets a precedent that other states can follow far more easily than city-based regulation. The scale advantage for Tesla is enormous. If a second state follows Arizona, the robotaxi network could jump from theoretical to operational faster than most analysts expect. Now, let's talk about FSD version 14.2. Elon Musk mentioned that this version is intended for broad release, and it marks a clear shift from improvement phase to deployment phase. Here's why. Version 14.2 introduces upgraded vision networks with dramatically higher resolution, improved emergent behavior prediction, and far more stable response patterns in complex city environments. It recognizes emergency vehicles more accurately, handles temporary closures and detours smoothly, and offers better human-like judgment for lane selection and speed adjustments. But here's the key insight. The biggest story is not the feature list, it's the timing. The rollout of V14.2 coincides perfectly with Arizona's regulatory approval. Tesla is synchronizing software maturity with real-world commercial opportunities. That is not a coincidence. That is strategic sequencing. This indicates Tesla believes FSD is entering a phase where reliability is sufficient for revenue generating applications, and that has massive implications for investors. To understand all of this, we need to place it into Tesla's broader strategy. For years, Tesla was seen as an EV manufacturer, but Tesla's internal view has been evolving towards something different, a mobility platform powered by AI. Think about the recent moves. Statewide Robotaxi approval, FSD entering broad rollout, short-term rental programs expanding, third-party supercharger partnerships, vehicle weight reduction for long-hour operation. These are not random updates, they are building blocks. Tesla is gradually shifting from a company that sells vehicles to a company that operates vehicles. And in the robo-taxi era, the real metric is not deliveries, it's utilization. A vehicle that earns money 20 hours a day represents a fundamentally different business model from one that sits idle in a driveway. And Tesla is architecting both hardware and software for that world. Weight reduction, that's not about performance. It's about lowering battery consumption per mile. Rental program, it's about introducing millions to the Tesla ecosystem through low friction trials. Third-party superchargers, that's about rapid scaling of the infrastructure needed for a robo-taxi network. Tesla is laying tracks for a future where the car is not the product. The service is the product. Let's shift to the investment angle. Today, the stock sits around $395, dipping below $400. Short-term price action does not reflect the structural changes happening beneath the surface. In the near term, noise will dominate. In the long term, business model transformation will dominate. Here's what matters for investors. Service revenue is valued far more highly than auto revenue. A robo-taxi fleet has far higher gross margins than vehicle sales. FSD subscriptions could become a recurring revenue engine. Regulatory approvals act as catalysts long before deployments begin. Infrastructure partnerships reduce Tesla's capital burden. Most analysts still model Tesla as a high-margin automaker. But if this shift continues, Tesla begins to look more like Uber without drivers, Apple with subscription ecosystems, Amazon with infrastructure leverage. The market has not priced this in, not even close. Here's something surprising that most people haven't noticed. Tesla's new short-term rental program, $60 a day, unlimited miles, free supercharging, should not be profitable. In fact, on paper, it looks like a money-losing business. But that is exactly the point. Tesla is not aiming to make money from rentals. Tesla is using rentals as a data acquisition engine. Every renter becomes an additional FSD trainer. Every mile driven becomes new training material. Every unfamiliar route becomes new learning territory. So yes, Tesla might lose a few dollars per rental. But if those data points accelerate FSD deployment by even a few weeks or months, the return on investment is exponential. Tesla has turned a seemingly unprofitable rental model into a strategic weapon, and no legacy automaker has anything comparable. Now let's project where this all leads. 2025 to 2027, we'll see more statewide approvals. FSD reliability will improve further. Rental users will grow, expanding the data footprint. Third-party supercharger networks will scale internationally. 2027 to 2030, if regulatory momentum continues, early robotaxi fleets could begin limited commercial service. Owners may start allowing their personal vehicles to operate autonomously overnight, creating a new passive income model. Tesla's revenue mix will gradually tilt from manufacturing towards services, data, and fleet operations. Longer term, a single robotaxi could generate several times its purchase price in lifetime revenue. This is why Elon Musk repeatedly emphasizes autonomy. The car becomes an earning asset, not a depreciating commodity. And this is where most investors misunderstand Tesla's upside. They focus on deliveries. But deliveries are just the entry point into the network. The true valuation lies in the network itself. So here is the long-term investor's perspective. The developments we covered today are not simply news. They are foundational steps toward a decade-long transformation of Tesla's business model. Arizona's approval signals regulatory momentum. FSD version 14.2 signals technological maturity. The rental program signals data expansion. Third-party superchargers signal scalable infrastructure. The weight reduction signals fleet optimization. If Tesla succeeds, the company will generate value not only through vehicle sales, but through mobility services, AI subscriptions, and global robotaxi networks. Short-term volatility will continue, but long-term, these structural changes matter far more than daily price action. For investors with a multi-year horizon, the question is not whether autonomy launches tomorrow. The question is whether Tesla is moving decisively toward that future. And everything we saw today suggests that it is. If you want deeper insights into how Tesla's strategy, AI progress, and long-term market impact evolve day by day, consider subscribing. I break down the signals behind the headlines so you can invest with clarity, not speculation. Thanks for watching, and let's continue exploring the future together. Before we wrap up, let me take a moment to introduce myself. I drive a Tesla Model Y, and at home, I've installed a Tesla Powerwall, so I actually charge my car with solar energy. I truly believe Tesla is shaping the future, and that's why I share the latest news and insights here on this channel. I'm from Japan, but I want to connect with Tesla fans all around the world. That's why I also create an English version of my videos. YouTube now lets you switch the audio into your own language, so you can enjoy it in whatever language you prefer. Most of all, I'd love to connect with Tesla fans everywhere so we can support Tesla together. I also share updates on X, so feel free to follow me there and let's connect. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to this channel. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.